In this lecture, we will discuss the coordinate systems, and it is to be noted about the coordinate systems that they are according to our choice. We just based on the geometry decide which coordinate system is better for us. And when we are having some plane geometries, then we use the Cartesian coordinate system. And when there is some curvature involved, then we use the curvilinear coordinate system. Inside the Cartesian coordinate system, we may have these coordinate system in 2D or 3D. And when we discuss them, these coordinate system, if we are having plane geometries, the plane geometry, then for a plane geometry, we use the Cartesian coordinate system in 2D and 3D. Cartesian coordinate system, and coordinate system. And when we are having a curved geometry, then we use the curvilinear coordinate system. The curvilinear coordinate system. Now, the coordinate system is independent of whatever the physical quantity we are studying. For example, if we are having a vector, then whether we consider the Cartesian coordinate system or a spherical coordinate system or a cylindrical coordinate system, because in the curved geometries we are having two systems involved, like one the spherical and the other the cylindrical. So both are curved geometries, and we will study them as well. So if we are having a physical quantity, so whether it's in a Cartesian coordinate system, we describe that one, or in a spherical coordinate system, or we describe it in a cylindrical coordinate system, there is no effect on the physical quantity, only our measurement will be different. So keep in mind this thing, that the physical quantity will not change based on our coordinate system, because our coordinate systems are invariant, and from one coordinate system we can go into another coordinate system. They are interchangeable, and the physical quantity will not depend on the coordinate system. Coordinate system is of our choice. Let's see, let me give you an example, that if I want to measure the length of the wall, the length of this board, for example, then is it's a planar geometry, so better I use a Cartesian coordinate system. But if I want to, instead of a scale, means which is a linear geometry, which is a Cartesian coordinate system, instead of a scale, if I want to find the length of this geometry with the help of a, let's say, a spherical thing, let's say with the help of a football, I want to measure the length of this, then I can do that measurement, and the measurement with both the systems, it will be the same, but the calculations will be difficult. So if I want to measure the, let's say, the circumference of a football or a circle, or the surface area of a football, then better I use a spherical coordinate system, then the calculations will be easier. I can use a Cartesian coordinate system for that one as well. The result will be the same, but the calculation will be much difficult. Similarly, if we will be having a cylindrical geometry, then for a cylindrical geometry, it's better to use the cylindrical coordinate system. The calculation will be easier. We can use any other geometry. It is independent of this which geometry we are using. But based on our geometry, we decide which coordinate system is better for this in order to do the things easily. So with this, we may have a two-dimensional coordinate system and a three-dimensional coordinate system. So let me start first with a two-dimensional coordinate system. And let's say we are having a coordinate system let me consider a two-dimensional coordinate system and Cartesian coordinate system I will discuss first. So this is two-dimensional Cartesian coordinate system. We call it a plane coordinate system as well. So in 2D Cartesian coordinates or plane Cartesian coordinates, let me write the axis here. This is the plane geometry. So I have one is the x-axis and the other is the y-axis, and this is x-axis, this is x and this is y. Similarly, this is origin, and on the other side we will have the negative values of x and the negative values of y. At the moment we are only considering the positive values of this. Means, let's say we are having a vector, and the vector is, let's say, r here in this system. Now this vector means it is in a plane of x and y, while the third dimension it will be perpendicular, which we will consider later, not now. This I can resolve into components, and this is the component which is along the x-axis, and this is its x component, which I can write as rx, or simply I write is x, while this is the y component of it, and I write it as y component. So I can write that the vector r is described in this planar coordinate system as r equal to, if this makes an angle with the axis and this angle is, let's say, some angle theta, which we will use later on in the polar coordinate system. But first let me write this one. Now it is x along x-axis, so it is equal to x in x unit vector plus y along y unit vector. So I have resolved this r into components, and now let me write this one. This is what will be the magnitude of this one. The magnitude of it is equal to the r, this one. So r magnitude, the square of this, the first component, plus the square of the second component, and then inside a square root. So r, this will give me the magnitude of r. So r magnitude, and this is equal to simple r here. So r equal x square plus y square square root. Now from here I can write that I have found what is r in terms of x and y. Now the theta angle, if I look at the theta, then it starts from here. As I have already told you, from where it starts, it is the base of it, and where it reaches, it is the high part. So the other remaining is the perpendicular. I can write from here that the angles, like for example from here, I know that cos theta is equal to the base over high part, and it is x over r, because the magnitude of r, high part is r. Similarly, sin theta I can write is y over r. And if I divide this equation by this equation, then I will have sin theta divide by cos theta, and I can get rid of r here. So sine is y over r, and then it will be over x. So 1 over cos theta, 1 over of this one will come out to be r over x. So r will go with r, and we are left with y over x. Now this side, I know that this is equal to tangent theta. Sine theta over cos theta is tangent theta, and this is equal to y over x, and this implies that theta will be equal to tangent inverse y over x. So I have found r, I have found theta. So what I did actually, I just converted this system, which is x and y coordinate system, and I converted this one into, means they are interconvertible, into r and theta, which I call the planar coordinate system, or the planar coordinates r and theta. They are interconvertible. If I know xy, I can calculate r, I can calculate theta. Similarly, if I know r and theta, then I can calculate the x and y. So here, this is the x, the coefficient here, the y coefficient are the component here, and then they can be easily converted into the plane polar coordinates r and theta, and r and theta we can reconvert with the help of these relations baked into this one. So this is a two-dimensional Cartesian coordinate system, and we successfully converted this one into plane polar coordinates. So these are the plane polar coordinates, and this way we proved that one coordinate system can be successfully converted into another coordinate system. And similarly, if we will have a third dimension involved here, like the z component is involved here, then for that one we will also go to the three-dimensional polar coordinate system. It will no more remain plane, because it will become 3D, and inside a 3D coordinate system we will then have the spherical polar coordinate system, and that we call is the curvilinear coordinate system.